Did you call me?
Sorry, I was just looking through your medicine cabinet. Okay, boring. No Valley of the Dolls stuff at all. Can't help but wondering why all the lubricants, though. Oh, hey, just, you know, tell me when you're ready. Take your time.
What did you
remember what I said about not drinking anything you didn't mix yourself? That's good advice for everyone. You know what? I'm sorry you were drugged for so long. I mean, I've never really done that before. And, oh, well, I swiped this from my dad. Didn't come with directions, and it's not like I could just ask him how much to use. So I probably used too much, or those screwdrivers could have affected my judgment, you think? It's real water. Scout's honor.
Why do I get tied up first if this is how we're gonna play?
Jeff, playtime is over. Now it's time to wake up.
This isn't funny. Is this some teenage joke?
Teenage? Yes. Joke? Patience. Just checking out the side of the house, okay?
You know, I saw this cop show once. It was great. And the killer, well, he thought he'd cleaned up all the evidence, but some of the victim's blood got on his shirt, and yeah, sure, he washed it, but some of the dried up blood got caught in the lint trap, so... I mean... Anything in here I should know about?
What the fuck are you doing?
That's kind of been my question, Jeff. What the fuck are you doing? Living in a house filled with pictures of half-naked teenage girls. Oh, none of whom you've ever done it with.
Help! Help! Help!
There was really no point in me taking any risks, Jeff. Technically, I could let you scream your fucking brains out, and no one is gonna hear you. Yeah, I waited till today because Mr. Coughlin is at work, and the Carrascos, well, they're vacationing in Santa Barbara. Still, I can't have some pedestrian just happening by as you're screaming, so shut up, or next time, it's gonna be bleach, okay?
Been stalking me?
Okay. All right, let's get this straight. You have been stalking me. I went into other chat rooms with different nicknames, and you would get to know each woman. And then, as soon as you found out they were any bit older than me, you would just drop them like that. You took your time. Sniffing out someone my age.
I didn't talk to the others because they were boring. You and I connected.
Oh, mm-hmm. Right.
Well, come on. You think I faked all that?
You know, actually, it's kind of funny. Because every time I would mention some, like, obscure singer or band,
You knew so much about them. But not right away. It was like a few minutes later. Maybe to give you enough time to look them up on the web. Jeff, you used the same phrases about Goldfrapp as they do on Amazon.com. Busted. By the way, I fucking hate Goldfrapp.
Come on. I wanted to impress you. Am I the first guy to do something stupid to impress a girl? Does that deserve being tied up and tortured?
Torture? Is this torture to you? Wow, I guess you've never read anything by Amnesty International or Human Rights Watch, because this... this is nothing. Of course you're not the first guy to lie to a girl, Jeff. The operative word there being girl. I mean, you know how old I am. What makes a kid who's barely passed her first period worth all this research? I mean, you really gotta start to wonder when a grown man goes through all this trouble just to charm a girl. Well, there's that word again, girl. You know, maybe it's this whole camera thing. Cameras, computers, they let you hide, don't they? So safe. I heard how your voice changed when the camera came between us.
My voice changed because I felt sick, because you drugged me.
Yeah, you were drugged, all right. And the drug was sweet. Little 14-year-old flesh.
Look, I'm a decent guy. Ask anyone. Go ahead. Call these models. They'll tell you.
Of course they will. You're not an idiot, Jeff. You don't piss where you live. Those girls were your work, and I, on the other hand, was... your play.
You were coming on to me.
Oh, come on. That's what they always say, Jeff.
Who?
Who? The pedophiles. She was so sexy, she was asking for it. Oh, she was only technically a girl. She acted like a woman. It's just so easy to blame a kid, isn't it? Just because a girl knows how to imitate a woman does not mean she's ready to do what a woman does. I mean, you're the grown-up here. If a kid is experimenting and says something flirtatious, you ignore it. You don't encourage it. If a kid says, hey, let's make screwdrivers, you take the alcohol away and you don't race them to the next drink.
Look, I've been lonely, okay? And that makes me stupid, but I'm not a pedophile.
Okay,
look, this is
what?
Some horrible mistake.
Lonely,
just untie me now. We'll forget
stupid.
This whole thing
and
happened. Just untie
time,
me now!
You might be a little peeved. So when I am ready to go, I'll call a cab and call another one to let you loose.
And when will that
be? I'm not sure yet.